I mean, your eyes and the teeth. You're not really supposed to do that, are you?
Not if I can avoid it. No.
Holly's sister, Lily.
Do you even give a shit about us, the strays?
That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
We're destroying the tree. No!
We're not burning the tree, Snow.
Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
I don't know. Snow'll come around. She's just... the crane thing hit her hard, and she doesn't really know who her friends are right now.
Oh, God, Bigby!
This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
Hey, everybody, it is I, MisterSkids, and I have a bit of a hard alcoholic beverage. Not very hard, it's just a hard soda, but something to strengthen my nerves to fight the fucking good fight, to fight the Crooked Man who has constantly been crooked, apparently. He killed his wife and his children just so he could make more power. So we are here to end the Crooked Man once and for all, hopefully. Oof. Okay. Here we go, guys. Here we go.
You've come a long way.
Yes, we have.
You must be tired.
Assess the situation.
And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently.
Jersey.
Please, Sheriff, relax for a moment, will you? Do you want a drink? Something to eat?
I don't want anything from you.
Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really, a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin.
I'm here for one reason, and it's not to eat your fucking
Yeah,
food.
Man.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey.
Yeah, you don't want another thrashing.
For the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You tried to kill me.
You forget what happened at the Pudding and Pie? You and your goons tried to kill me!
I'm truly sorry for that whole debacle. It was not my intention to put you or Miss White in any sort of danger.
Sure.
My wish was merely to take Crane, Sheriff. And as soon as the assignment grew out of control, I put a stop to it. I know that that doesn't change what happened to you. And I can only offer my sincerest apologies.
You didn't stop it out of the kindness of your heart. You stopped it because Snow White offered up Crane.
And if he hadn't...
That may have appeared to you to be the case, but I assure you...
Yeah, right.
And I hope you believe me when I say, Sheriff, that I sincerely mean to make it up to you.
Uh-huh.
The recent murders that have gotten such attention as of late, I don't relish telling you that they were perpetrated by an employee of mine.
Hmm.
It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally.
Mm.
I just want to settle the issue for you and to assure you that it's over with. You really don't need to worry yourself further.
No, I need to know.
An unfortunate bit of business. You're gonna tell me right now who killed him.
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information.
You will divulge the information or I will make your life a hell.
You shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation? The man said he'd take care of it.
I'm
the law.
So
why don't you take the hint and get out?
Tweedledee, please.
I'm the law here, not you. Now tell me who did it.
You think I'm scared of you? You're nothing more
than
a...
That's enough.
I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but... In the interest of preserving our alliance, if you have to know, it was Georgie.
What?
However, like I said, I'll be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie.
You got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down now.
I had a feeling it was Georgie. He seems like a scumbag who would do that.
Yeah, I killed him, so what?
Why'd you do it?
You should have just kept your nose where it fucking belongs.
You're going to die.
Georgie.
Why'd you do it? Why kill them?
Does it matter?
Yes.
Look, the fact is, George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. That you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right bollocks, sis. You're just gonna let him do this?
Like they're gonna help you. Also, I saw the opium pipe.
Sheriff, can we discuss terms?
What do you want?
You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
What the hell?
Take this fucker. Take all of them. I didn't fucking
Don't
start
make
this.
Any trouble, Georgie.
Are you seriously throwing me under the fucking carriage after everything I've done for you?
All right. Let's
talk. Let's take George.
You can't just hand me over. What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You think I'll give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers
just
are?
Just get the fuck out of here!
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him! Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit.
You...
But he's not taking me anywhere.
Georgie.
I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen.
What are you saying? Yeah, what the fuck? You're gonna make sure we all go down this shitter with you? I told you!
Grab him! Fucking take him!
Get the fuck away!
Grab him!
He's the one you fucking want!
Oh yeah, I'll take the crooked
this
man
could have gone
later!
So well. But you just had to complicate things.
Of course I do, because you're an asshole, crooked man.
The truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
Bloody Mary, oh shit!
Did I miss anything good?
Fuck.
Well, look at you all fixed up.
Oh my god. None of this now. Get fucked. I'm gonna kick all of your asses.
Take this.
Oh no. Oh no. Nope.
You're done, Wolf.
No, I am.
Come on. We're pretty much done here.
Get off me. Get off. Oh, nice. Hi, Georgie. I'm going to rip your arms off now. Hope you like being alive, because you're not going to be for very much longer.
Oh, God.
Oh. Ah, nope. Get the fuck out of here with that shit.
This way.
Yeah. Get against that wall. Well, I'm going to fucking lay the beat down on you. If I can't have one of you, if I can't have the men that fucking screwed me over, I'll take somebody else. I will take you all down with me.
Come on, Georgia.
Ooh, shit.
I know.
Hello, friends. It's time to die. It's time for you to die. Nope. Nope, you're not going anywhere. Oh boy, what am I doing here? What am I doing? Okay, I see. There we go. Jesus Christ, this is horrifying. This is very scary shit ass piss. Up, going up, we're going up. W, we got this. Go, Big Bear, kick the ass. Kick all that ass. There he is. I thought that was him, but another. Oh God, I am horrifying everybody right now. There he is. Let's go, Bigby! Let's kick some ass! Let's get that Georgie motherfucker! I'm guessing the bar at the bottom is how much time I have left before he gets away. We can't let him get away. We cannot. Yes?
Fuck! What was that?
Your death! Your demise! Oh, hello! That was the fucking crooked man, damn it! Fuck! I let the crooked man get away.
Take him off!
I can't!
God damn it, I shouldn't have let the crooked man get away! Oh, get up, Bigby! He's just gonna run you over! Oh, never mind. I was wrong. Get up, Bigby. We gotta go, man. I'm sorry, Bigby, but you gotta go. Oh, boy.
Gun it.
Are you sure?
Do it.
You're dead.
He's not moving.
Keep going.
Okay. Do we get him? Come on, man. We got this, Sheriff. You are the sheriff. You are the power.
Come on.
Right to the pudding and pie, really? You must have some kind of defenses if he's... Oh, hey. We just so happened we had clothing there. Damn it, I didn't know that was the crooked man next to him. If I had known that, I would have gone for him. But apparently, no, I don't get no such choice. Apparently there was clothing just like mine that I just... Cool. Cool about that. What? Okay. I guess I go through the door. He had to have had a reason to come this way. He must be looking for a weapon or a gun or something.
Come on. We can't stay here.
Yeah, he's getting something.
I need a minute.
Okay.
What do you got?
Can you stand up? It's okay. Take your time. Slowly.
Oh, it's no fucking use. No way I'm walking out of here.
How did this happen, Georgie? How did it get this?
Don't. Fuck. Well, it won't be your fault. It'll all land on me in the end.
But it isn't.
No, it's...
Hey, Georgie. I hated you from the beginning. You are a vile piece of trash. You and that fucking crooked man, and you both are going to pay. Pay dearly. Hi.
I hope you come to your senses.
For
Crooked Man's the one you want.
Yes, it is.
But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go. That it, Sheriff. I had to say goodbyes first.
I'm taking you in, Georgie. Let's go.
You gonna carry me?
Yep.
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
Vivian, you don't know what you're doing.
I'm trying to help you here.
You can't seriously want to protect this guy. You know what he did.
I'm not going anywhere.
Well, get the fuck out of my way.
It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
What?
He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then.
You were...
You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too. You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to! You can't fucking blame me for that.
Look,
Sometimes you just have to do what you're told. Then it comes back to bite you in the ass because some good-for-nothing crooked bastard decides you're not worth shit anymore.
Why'd you do it, then?
Yeah.
If it's not your fault, then what the fuck happened?
Look, Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the crooked man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again.
You're just a piece of...
Because it's not my fault. The crooked man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out. The both of you can go rot in hell.
Georgie.
You think I'm the one to fucking blame?
That's not what I meant. I was just trying...
You're still the one who pulled the trigger. Nobody held your hand and made you go through it.
Yeah.
Fine. Believe what you want. I can tell you've made up your mind. Doesn't matter if it's fucking true or not. Go ahead and arrest me then. But it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing. It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this
shit. I'm blaming all of you, not just you.
George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault.
You are a bad guy.
But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know? At the end of the day, you're just like him. Coming here, talking about options, like it was that simple.
You could have done anything else. You could have let them go. You could have freed Faith and Lily from those fucking ribbons instead of murdering them.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them... What would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die... Do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you doing?
I told you, you don't know the fuck about anything.
Wait, how is she involved in all this?
This is the original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off, couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
Oh my God.
I promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here either.
I know that. But did it have to be like
this? How could you?
How could you do this?
How?
I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand. Nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were gonna be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the Crooked Man showed up and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell. Save the fucking day.
Stop it.
I told you, sometimes all your options are shit. What the fuck are you supposed to do then?
We'll find another way. She doesn't have to die. Maybe the witches
don't
can...
Don't talk about me like I'm not even here. Please. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say? It's my life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
I wasn't really...
Just shut up.
You're right. It's your life.
I know what I've done.
Wait.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here. But it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily? To all of them?
Vivian, wait.
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them. What I took away from them. I look at Nerissa and I hate myself.
Vivian.
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Don't. No.
Vivian, no.
Oh.
Fuck.
Vivian.
No.
No.
Why'd you have to do that, Vivian? Vivian.
Damn it.
No.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just... Oh, fuck!
Get up. Get up!
Don't think so, Bigby.
It looks bad. Oh.
I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the Crooked Man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right? For both of us. You know the bastard deserves it. Make a promise to a dying man. Give him hell.
He's gonna have it worse. Don't worry.
Good. Old foundry by the river. All right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You wanna finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you wanna do, right? Well, whatever it is, just get it over with. I'm not sticking around for much longer.
That's not who I am.
Prove it then. No more games, all right? We both know how this ends. Just make it quick. I know what I did. Let's not draw this out.
Fine.
All right, Georgie.
I'm sorry, Georgie. God. They weren't bad people. I mean, they weren't great people. They were horrible people, but it's not like they deserved what they got. I'm sorry. I didn't know the whole picture. I judged Georgie. He was a terrible person, but I don't think he really deserved such a brutal way to die. God damn it, I didn't want Vivian to die. She didn't deserve to die. But she made a giant mistake. They all both did. They made big mistakes. I'm sorry. I don't like what they did, but they didn't deserve to die like that because it was all fucking Crooked Man's fault anyway. And Crooked Man is more than likely ready for me. Let's end this shit.
Still warm. He's here, alright.
Alright. God. I had a feeling it was Georgie because it was his girls. But I didn't think. I knew the Crooked Man had to be involved as well. And I'm not at all surprised it was Georgie who pulled the trigger, but it was the Crooked Man who decided to end it all. Like I thought. I was pretty damn sure that they were trying to run away from that life, and Crooked Man was the one in complete wanted the complete control of the situation. Hold on. And so he had them both murdered. The piece of shit. And he's going to die too. God damn it, I can't kill him. Fucking Snow White made me promise that I have to bring him in alive. Damn it. Shepherd Metalworks. Ha, I get it. You know, wolves, shepherd. I get it. But nice pun there, game.
So this is where they've been sending these.
Oh, so this is where all the this is where all the magic is. He's got probably a horde of fucking weapons and magic behind him. Well, that light turned on. That's good. Good to know. Yep, he's going to be ready for me. He's going to try and kill me. He's got a
Bigby Wolf.
Yeah.
The big bad wolf.
Bitch. Now here's a bitch that deserves to die. Mary. Let's see how fucking tough you are without your gun. There's a locked coffin. What the hell's up with that? Ichabod Crane, Beauty, Jack Horner, Mr. Toad, Flycatcher. Bluebeard? I knew it! Debts! Debts! I knew it! They all owe a debt to the Crooked Man. All of them. Beauty does. Mr. Toad owes him. The Flycatcher. Ichabod. Even Bluebeard. I knew it. Something. Boy Blue is collateral. Rose Red. Fucking Snow White's sister. Surveillance. King Cole and Snow White, they've been keeping an eye on... Oh my good lord, they've been keeping an eye on me for sure. Oh boy. Holy shit. What do we got here? Yep, they've been keeping tabs on me. Oh, there's me and Snow. There's me at the Lucky Pond. There's Lily. There's Snow White with, what's her name? Fucking, Holly. They've been keeping tabs on all of us. There's a torture, the torture
they
we-
used to fear you.
Look at me, I was just like, get fuck it, I don't care.
Small shivering bodies would fit.
Bitch. Bleach. To get rid of the blood in the hammer to make people crooked. Just like the Crooked Man himself. Hello, I stopped for some reason, but I guess I was just... Whatever. Whatever, I don't care. Shit is real. Shit is so fucking real right now. Where are you hiding? And do you... I hope to God you don't have a silver gun. You do. Look at that. They've been making special silver bullets just for me. Here's the cartridges.
Silver.
Yep.
The big bad wolf.
Oh, where did you come from now?
It's about time you showed up.
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate.
You're dead, fuckhead.
Come find me when you finish, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way, now. Don't make this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Oh, damn!
Wow, what a man. Stealing punches while my back is turned.
You did it! You're first!
Did you teach you to fight proper?
Nope. Nope. Yeah, get fucked. Goddamn Bloody Mary. Where the hell did she go? Goddamn, she's slippery. She must have went through a reflection nearby. She is quick. Holy shit. I think I chose wrong. That was probably a really bad choice. And should have probably predicted where her movements were going to be. Oh, God. Damn. Where is she? Where could she be? Oh, okay. I'm moving silently. This is a really bad idea. This is a really, really bad idea, Bigby. What is she? Oh, fuck. I pressed D. Come on, man. Ah, fuck you. I didn't deserve that hit. Did not deserve it. I'm gonna stare you out. You deserved a cranium crunch. Okay, What? Fuck you. I hit that. Yeah. That time I got it. Ow. Damn it.
Where are you?
How is she doing this?
Come on, face me.
Oh. Oh my good god. She is more terrifying than I thought I could. Holy shit. Well now. Hello, terror of the night. With flapping wings and everything. Ouch. Ouch. Arr. Get him! Oh, she is slippery like a son of a bitch. Ah, dodge! God damn it, dodge! Get off me, you whore! Get off! Off! Yeah! Oh, I did it too quick. Otherwise, I think I would have gotten her in the lava shit. But then I would have fell in the lava shit. Oh, now I've gone full wolf again. Oh boy, here she comes. Miss Trinkle. Tinkle-linkle. Miss Tinkle-linkle, would you like to tinkle-linkle in your piss? Oh god, there's more than one. Oh. What the fuck? What are you even? What horrifying monstrosity are you? No wonder she's been moving so fast. There's more than one of her. Yeah, that's one down. About 100 dozen to go. Ow. Up W. Slash. Yes. Die. Ouch. Oh my god, there is way too many of them. There is just so many of them. What am I supposed to do? Get him. Get off, you shattery bitch. Get dead. Where am I? Am I in like a nightmare? That's what it feels like. This doesn't feel like reality. This isn't reality. Oh no. Full wolf mode has been activated. Oh my god. They're just reflections of her. They're not real. Yeah, that's not happening. Squish. Get her. Rip her head off. Just like fleas. Like horribly sharp fleas. Everywhere you look. Fleas. That's the real one. Get out of my way. God damn it, they're everywhere, Jesus Christ. What do I do? Matt and the Madness. Oh my God, what is he preparing to do? Oh my God. He huffed and he puffed and blew these motherfuckers away. Bye. Now I see why they call them the Big Bad Wolf. Holy shit. Bigby is fucking insanely huge. Is that silver? No, she might be preparing some silver. Oh. Oh, I got her. But if she was a reflection, that wasn't the real Mary. That wasn't the real Mary. I don't think that was the real Mary. Are you gonna be pantsless, man? Damn, Bigby. I did not see that coming. Nope. Conveniently, your clothes are right over here. Hello. Crooked man. Let me guess, you got silver for me. You got a silver bullet. You're ready and waiting with a gun.
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
I knew it.
This gun holds 6 rounds of specially designed silver bullets. Now, I may not be the best shot, but I can guarantee that at least one bolt will meet its mark. And you'll find yourself rolling on the floor in agony, unable to heal yourself. Without Swineheart to save you, you'll die. Is that reason enough for you? Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want. You plan to do what she says, don't you?
You sure about that?
Yes, I'm quite sure.
Why do you want to go back?
You will bring me back alive.
Why?
Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community.
Why should I give you that?
I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial. Are we clear?
Why would you want that?
The whole town will be calling for your execution. Why would you want me to bring you back there?
Why don't you let me worry about that?
Crooked man.
Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women.
Yes, you did.
And I think you know that.
You did.
All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
Maybe you didn't carry it out. I don't think Georgie was lying when he said you ordered their deaths.
Yeah.
Georgie would have said anything to save himself. We both know that.
True, but you are under his thumb.
Not a killer.
Liar. There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will. As long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. And I don't think I'm being unreasonable. If you decide to do something stupid, like murder me, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here?
I care about justice. I mean,
do you really want the truth? Or do you just want to look like the hero? Because those are two very different things.
This is about justice. I'm the sheriff. I have to do what's right. 2 people were murdered.
And you know who did it.
It was you. You murdered those girls. Georgie. You control everybody. You're a monster.
He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
Yeah.
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in. But you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going? I'd rather not dawdle. You know, I'm actually looking forward to seeing Miss White again. My previous interactions with her have gone rather well.
You're not...
Oh, I don't think so. We're not doing this your way.
How unfortunate. I was hoping we could make this work.
Die! Die!
What are you gonna do now? Rip me apart like some kind of animal? Killing me here would achieve nothing. And what would Miss White think? You show up with nothing but a corpse. No answers, no proof. You'll never know the truth, and she'll barely stand to look at you. Is it worth it?
Die! Kill him! Kill him! Kill him now!
This is it for you!
Sorry! You don't deserve a fair trial!
You said enough!
You do not deserve life! You do not deserve anything, Crooked Man! Die! 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 You deserved nothing of the sort. You brought nothing but pain and misery to people. You don't deserve a fair trial. You're guilty as charged.
Where the hell is Bigby?
Oh, come on!
Where is he?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, any minute. And then we'll get started. I really appreciate you taking the time. I know it's short notice, but given the circumstances...
Here's your fucking crooked man.
What have you done?
Oh God.
Brought justice.
Shit.
He killed him. Holy shit.
I didn't think you had it in you, Bigby.
Stop it.
Goodbye.
You ripped him apart. I told you to bring him back alive.
You really fucked him up.
What did you do? He's all...
You did this to him?
Why?
Okay, everyone. Just calm down.
I thought I wanted him gone, but this...
It's terrible. No, it isn't.
What the hell happened? Tell me. Tell me why you did this.
I think it's pretty clear.
He nearly ripped his head off.
Please, explain yourself.
It just... Everything was happening so fast, I didn't have time to think about it. I just did it.
That's your excuse?
Look at him.
Oh, God.
Would it have been that hard to restrain him? Did you really have to murder the man?
Yes.
Hang on. It's not murder.
Then what would you call it?
Justice, maybe?
Yep.
This is not justice!
Yes, it is.
You know it's not.
Why not?
This is Bigby Wolf doing whatever the hell he wants.
Which, in this case...
You can't do things like this anymore.
Maybe it's not justice.
You think?
Then what is it?
What are you getting on his case about? He did the right thing here. If this fucker killed Lily...
And Faith.
How can we be sure of that? Without a trial... What evidence do we have? We never had anything concrete. That's why we needed him here.
Are you telling me the killer might still be out there?
Why'd you kill him then?
Crooked Man was the prime suspect. But without his testimony, we have nothing.
We don't need a trial. I know the Crooked Man ordered it done. He made Georgie kill those girls.
Georgie?
Where's Georgie now? If we bring him in for questioning, we... What? Where is he?
Bigby, is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not.
Well, where is he?
Sheriff?
Georgie was a victim of this psycho, too. He was pushed into the whole thing.
Yep.
That doesn't answer the question.
Georgie and the Crooked Man were guilty of murder. And I made sure they couldn't hurt anyone else.
You mean...
So he's dead. Is that what you're telling
me? I didn't mean to kill him. That one I didn't mean to do.
I don't even know what to say to you right now.
Maybe that's not such a bad thing.
You're on board with this?
I don't know. I mean, it's not like the crooked man didn't deserve it. And if Georgie killed him...
You think anyone deserves this?
Yes. He was a monster. He was a monster.
Your job is to keep Fabletown safe. The minute you start abusing your position by attacking people, we betray the trust of this community. And killing those people out there, on your own, without due process, it makes us look
like killers?
How could you do this?
It's just one thing after another.
Look, I'm glad he's fucking dead.
But like this?
What does it really matter?
I did get carried away.
Any of us.
Things got out of hand. I just wasn't thinking.
I can't believe this. I made myself very clear. This is not okay.
Snow's right. This is disgusting.
Oh, it's much worse than that.
What? Are you guys buddy-buddy with the crooked man all of a sudden? What the fuck is wrong with you?
Grant.
Everyone, that's enough. Bigby, I can't protect you without the support of this community. The minute you kill another suspect, I won't be able to stop them from calling for your resignation.
And yours.
If that happens, I can't defend you. Do you understand?
He's not gonna listen to you.
Okay, Snow. I get it.
Do you? Listen, maybe you were right this time about the Crooked Man, but what happens when you're wrong? The second you make a mistake about someone, I won't watch you become a murderer.
I think it's too late for that.
Not a murderer.
I'm not a murderer.
Good.
So how do you explain that?
That's not...
Bigby, don't.
Having some personnel issues, Miss White? Can't control your mutt?
Bluebeard, this is hardly the time.
It looks like as long as the wolf thinks you're guilty, he has free rein to murder you in your sleep.
No, that's not how-
Is this what we can expect from now on?
Yeah, you make one mistake and Bigby's gonna rip your head off?
Hey,
one mistake?
Nah, he'll just bat you around for a while. Make sure you get thoroughly fucked up.
That's not going to happen.
Or just beat us to death.
Are we even protected anymore? If we're throwing out the charter-
We're not throwing out the charter.
How do you expect to enforce that?
Don't be ridiculous, Beast. I'm not about to-
You think I'm being ridiculous? We all know what you're capable of. You nearly gouged my eyes out.
Beast, please, the sheriff isn't going
to- You see? The wolf does whatever the hell he wants, and the princess is no better.
Now, hang on a minute.
You don't believe me? They came to my apartment, and then for no earthly reason, she wanted my tree destroyed.
What?
Why would you do that?
We didn't destroy it.
She was helping people glamour themselves as other fables. We couldn't let that continue.
I can't say I'm fucking surprised.
I am. Snow, how could you do that?
You tried to ruin my life for no reason at all.
What else were we supposed to do?
Don't blame Snow.
Don't blame Snow. She had her reasons. Greenleaf was using her magic to help Crane and the Crooked Man. That's why Snow wanted your tree burned.
That's not why.
Yes, it was.
You can pretend it's about law and order, but it's time you stopped lying to yourself. You wanted to get back at me for what Crane did. But that doesn't justify it. You both just act out of your own selfish desires. It doesn't matter what's right. At this point, I'd rather have Crane.
You don't mean that.
Yeah, you...
At least Crane didn't kick the shit out of everybody.
Or destroy what's ours.
He also earned the position.
Don't start.
He left us alone.
Things will only get worse now.
You can't really believe that.
What the hell is wrong with you? You fucked up your own lives. Dealing with criminals, making your own bad fucking choices. And now you want to blame us for your screwed up situation. I've been trying to fix the mess you made.
How dare you?
Is this how it's gonna be?
You're gonna blame us.
Bigby's right. You people don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Do you seriously think you want Crane back? He was an asshole, and he didn't do shit for any of you. Snow and Bigby found my sister when Crane wouldn't even look.
Yeah, but they only came around when they thought it was Snow White who ate it.
No, they cared about Lily. They care about all of us. Even if they've got a funny way of showing it sometimes.
Thank you, Holly.
Oh, come on, Holly. Maybe Snow gives a fuck, but Bigby? I mean, this I get. but I didn't do shit wrong, and I got tossed around your fucking bar.
That was different, Gren.
Holly's right. Crooked Man took over my shop, but Bigby tried to help me out.
Everyone, please, just calm down.
We have a right to be heard.
Are you afraid of what we have to say?
This isn't helping.
I'm not finished.
Like we give a shit.
Need some help, Miss White?
Just a minute.
This can't continue.
Listen.
I still have something to say.
Listen, friends.
But I was...
Please. It isn't Bigby's fault. He can't control his nature. And frankly, I wouldn't dare ask him to try. Just as a scorpion stings, the wolf must bite. But with a sheriff so impulsive, shouldn't the new deputy mayor have at least some command over her office?
Bluebeard?
Are either of them fit to run this town?
Can I say something?
Excuse me?
Narissa.
Who the hell is she?
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, please step
Let
aside.
Let her speak,
Wait.
Man.
How long have you been standing there?
Let her speak, Bluebeard.
Let her speak.
But...
Let her speak.
Yeah, fucking shut up.
I haven't been able to speak my mind for a long time. We were prisoners at that club. We had nowhere to go. No one cared enough. Certainly not Crane. You're acting like they haven't done anything good in the last few days, but you know that's not true. Because of the sheriff and Snow, I can finally talk about what happened to me. To all of us. We're free now. And I think that should count for something.
Thank you, Narissa. She's right. We haven't been there for you in the past, and I'll be the first to admit we've made plenty of mistakes. But I truly want what's best for this town, and we're trying to make things right. And that may not always be clear right away, but I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And I'm sure Bigby does too. It's going to take some time to clean up Crane's mess, but he's gone now. The Crooked Man is dead. The killer has been found, and you can all rest easy knowing we're here to look out for you. I'll make sure of it.
While that's all very touching, is it enough? I'm still not convinced Miss White has what it takes to control the sheriff, or run this town.
I am. We haven't really given them a chance. Crane just left. Let's see what Snow and Bigby can do on their own.
I trust Snow to do right by us. Bigby, too.
Thanks, Holly.
I think they've had enough chances.
Things are finally changing around here. Maybe you don't feel it, but I do. Bigby and Snow are good for Fabletown.
She's right. Now that things have settled down, I'm sure they can do better.
And we will.
Yes, exactly.
Right, Sheriff?
We'll do better. We'll do better.
Of course we will. We're not like Crane. We'll look out for you.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Goodbye, Crooked Man.
You see that?
It's finally over.
You didn't...
Good riddance, at least.
This won't end well.
Shit.
It's over now.
Goodbye, Crooked Man. May you rot in hell. Goodbye, Crooked Man. You brought a lot of pain. You brought a lot of suffering. You brought a lot of death. But we, even when you said that we wouldn't get past this, that I, by killing you, I was going to make everything worse for Fabletown, you were wrong. We are on our way to making a better, more caring office for the Fables so that they can all live in peace without having to worry about some monster hanging on looming over their back like you. Be gone, demon. Goodbye. Holy shit. Holy shit. That was intense. That was really intense. I couldn't even speak for a long time. It was just too much. Just too much. I couldn't.
Hey, Sheriff.
Flycatcher.
Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
Hi, everyone.
This fucking line.
Fucking. Jack, what are you doing?
Oh, Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
I'm sorry. About what happened with the crooked man. I didn't...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this.
Sorry, Snow.
We'll talk later, okay?
We couldn't let him live. He was a monster. Fucking Bluebeard.
You're late.
Bluebeard. Fuck. Fuck.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
Colin, god damn it. You could get me in trouble, man. Damn it. You need to get glamored. We'll get you glamored, man. We'll get you glamored. Don't worry. It's gonna be a little bit... It probably will cost me money, but at least we'll get you glamored. Hopefully this doesn't fuck with my game too much with this frame dropping. Web and Muffet Market. Nice. Hey, Toad, you didn't get glamored. God damn it, Toad.
I'm going. Jesus.
Toad, god damn it. I told you to get glamored.
We only have like 5 minutes.
Carry me for fuck's sake. I don't give a shit.
You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Moaning, Sheriff.
Nice
fucking day.
I gave you money.
Shit.
Don't be so...
Just go grab that, would you?
I tried to help, man.
Sorry about all this. I tried to help.
Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'll get another chance. But Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway. I told her I had the money, but she didn't want to hear it.
I'm sorry.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby. I have something.
That's not fair. I
you
gave.
Know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Yeah.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so. If you could bring it to her.
Sure.
She was nice.
TJ, so... sure, of course.
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best.
Aww.
It's a willow beetle.
Oh, no.
That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
Yeah,
she
TJ.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, TJ. But, look on
I
the
tried.
Bright side, okay?
I really did.
Plenty of space to run around. And a nice river nearby so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundy seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
I'm sorry.
We're all set.
I'm so
Bye,
sorry.
Mr. Wolf.
I'm
Goodbye,
sorry, TJ. I really...
Hey, Bigby. Where's your friend, Colin? Where's the fucking pig?
How should I... He must be missing.
I don't know. He, must have run off.
Bullshit.
I'm sorry, he didn't... It's not my fault. I'm sorry, Toad. I really am. I'm sorry, TJ.
Saying goodbye?
They didn't deserve that. They didn't deserve that. I gave them the money so they could get glamored. I'm sorry. Snow, unfair. God damn it, Snow.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh, yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
I understand.
It's okay. I get it.
Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
Oh no. What do you have?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily.
Oh no. Please.
Not sure where to start.
Please tell me that I didn't make a mistake.
Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand.
Oh, no.
You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they'd go just to silence someone who had physical evidence? I had to.
It's okay. Just calm down.
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
You were just trying to protect them.
Yeah. You didn't...
Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... Oh, God.
Sorry. You did what you had to in a horrible situation.
I don't know what happened. But that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us.
Oh,
we
no.
had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie... It was my fault. I sold them out, and
I'm
she
so sorry.
Just...
I'm so sorry. That's horrible.
That night, after Faith, I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
It's you. I was wondering about that.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her, just hoping that maybe if I couldn't save them, could at least save the rest of us.
You were trying to get my attention.
I was wondering who put the head there.
You started all this.
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. Mm. We just fade like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
Won't happen.
It's going to be different now. I promise. Things like that won't happen anymore. Not while I'm around.
You'll make things right. You and Snow.
Thanks, Nerissa.
Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
Snow doesn't really need me.
I'm sure that's not true. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened. When no one else would. You knew when to show mercy, and you brought justice to this town. Finally. If you hadn't killed the Crooked Man back there, He would have just talked his way out of it like he always does.
I knew he would.
From where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I've been making a lot of mistakes lately.
But you've also done a lot of good. Don't forget that.
Thanks,
Theresa. You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you.
Thank you, Narissa.
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
Oh God, please don't let her die next. Please don't let her die next. Please, that's what Lily said.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me. You like my ribbon? Do you like it?
Faith wore one too. Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little
Did
Mermaid.
Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests.
What?
I hope you find what you're looking for.
Wait a minute. Wait, go after her.
I'll see you around, Wolf.
Is Faith actually still alive? But that's weird. That's weird. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I really don't. I do not know. Something seems rather odd about that. What did you do? Due to Georgie, 68% of players actually killed Georgie. Did you give Crooked Man a trial? Only 10% of players actually killed the Crooked Man at the Foundry. Oh, man. That doesn't really reflect well on me, does it? Oh, boy. Did you walk out of the Witching Well? 84% of players stayed until the end, and I stayed all the way to the end. Did you accept TJ's gift for Snow? 98% of you. Fucking, who was the 2.5% that picked to not accept TJ's gift? Because you are a cold, heartless son of a bitch. More so than I am. More so than I am. And what were your last words to Narissa? 29% of players said, I made a lot of mistakes. And which I did. I made a lot of mistakes. There was people I could have saved the prince, but I didn't save the prince because I wasn't good enough. I didn't make a good enough decisions, and I made mistakes along the way, but we finally ended the Crooked Man. We finally finished him, got rid of him, and I know that it wasn't a good idea to give him a fair trial, but we were able to work it so that they realized that the Crooked Man was behind it all, and I know that he was behind it all. And with Narissa saying what she did, I'm pretty sure the entire time that the Crooked Man was the one hiding out. And I'm not sure about the whole at the end where Narissa just said what she did, but yeah. I need to figure out, there was something more to this story than what meets the eye, but at least we got some scumbag off the fucking streets. He did not deserve to live, I'm sorry, but, okay, the special stats? Okay. You lied to him about seeing Beauty outside the apartment. You impressed her with your detective skills. You fought him after the interrogation. Butcher, you offered him a protection at the business office. Colin, you gave him a drink when he asked for one in the apartment and you helped him avoid the farm. Faith, you gave her money after the fight with the woodsman. Georgie, you took money from Georgie's cafe. You offered her a job, Greenleaf. Gren, you drank with Gren after Lily's funeral. Snow, you brought her along with you to the trip chap and you promised to bring her the Crooked Man back alive. I know I thought I was going to be able to keep that promise, but he was just going to talk his way out of things. Tiny Tim, you chose to wait for him. TJ, you accepted the beetle and promised to give it to Snow. Toad, you stood up for him when Snow wanted to send him to the farm. You gave him the money, and it still did not end well for poor Toad. Ah, there's that sound again. Oh, man, what a trip. Oh, my God. That is the end of season one of the big bad wolf, the wolf among us. Oh my god, why isn't there a season two? Why is there not a season two yet? God damn it, god damn it, Telltale. Why are you making Minecraft a fucking story arc instead of making this a story arc? Do you not have any more ideas? Because you could listen to your fans, maybe. Maybe they have some ideas. They could probably give you something. I mean, there's so much to work with. I mean, you have a basis. You have a basis already to the next one. You need to, like, I don't know, fix it? Fix that you don't have a season two? Because we want a season two. We want a season two, guy, man, palios. No wonder everybody wants a season two. I've been looking up on the internet. Everybody and their fucking grandmother who's played this game wants a season two. And it's fucking top notch. I still feel uneasy about my decisions. That's kind of hard to get with a game sometimes. But these guys did it well. Now, and I have to live with the decisions that I made during this game, and I could have made some really, really bad decisions. And you. And special thanks to me. Yay. Or something like that. So, yeah. And, like, killing the Crooked Man, I feel bad for. I mean, I really do. But he had to die. He was a horrible monster of a human being, and he needed to die. Anyway, yeah. I know I'm defending the horrible things that I did. Continue the story. Pick up the graphic novel today. I would love to. I can't afford those, though. But if season two comes out, I'd be fucking for sure to pick that up. Oh, man. Oh, man. Come on, season two. I'm ready for season two. I'm ready for more Bigby. I'm ready for more Snow. I'm ready for it all. Give it to me, baby. Yeah, give it to me. Give it to me. Give me more decisions. Give me more. I don't know if it's recording. Okay, it's recording again. Give me more. So let's, before I turn off the game, let's take a look at the Book of Fables, shall we? Shall we take a quick look at the last Book of Fables, huh? Okay, I didn't get all of these because I made different decisions, so I can't get them all in one playthrough. I'd have to play it again and make different decisions to unlock all of these. And what I'm going to do now, guys, is I'm going to play this. If you guys want to see the rest of it, read the rest of these Book of Fables here and learn more knowledge, you can go right ahead. But for all of you that don't want to read these, I thank you all for tuning in, and I hope to see you all next time. Bye, guys! Bah!